Hi, everybody. I'm Dr. Borsair. I wanted to record you a quick video to replace the one that's on Blackboard because, frankly, that one is old and out of date, and I wanted to freshen it up for you a bit. So I'm Dr. Borsair. Boar is in the pig, seer is in what you do with the pig. You can call me Dr. B. That's really what I go by. And I wanted to just kind of introduce myself because while we're only going to be online this semester, there is a person on the other side of that screen, and I wanted you to know who I am and show you around our Blackboard site a little bit. So let me start with the introductions. I am Dr. Borsier. Boar is in the pig, seer is in what you do with the pig, but I said you can call me Dr. B. Who am I? Well, I was born in Michigan and I grew up in the Thumb. I grew up in real cow country where, I truly did pest cows on the way to school. I graduated with only 23 other kids in my class. My mom was a returning to college returning college student when I was in second grade. And so I got to see what probably a lot of you are doing, where I was a kid and my mom was a student. I got to see that. I got to see how she studied and how hard she worked. And she actually ended up retiring from microbiology, a professorial position at U of M Flint. My dad, he's Austrian. He is old world Austrian. These are my parents up here. He is 90 years old as of August. That definitely shaped who I was, having a dad with some very old world views. He's also, he was a precision machinist. So he grew up in the trades. He was an apprentice, a classic apprenticeship. So I had that kind of experience that shaped me as well, that perhaps academia isn't the only thing. I went to U of M Flint for undergrad, Michigan State University for grad school. I live in Mason with my husband. In fact, I'm coming to you right now from, this is my condo. I can't drive from Mason to go to work in a normal semester. And so when I first started at Grand Rapids, I bought this condo so that I could live here during the school year. And then I would walk to work, because I'm really close, and I'd walk to work. And then during the breaks and summer, I would go home to Mason. Now, this semester, I'm teaching hybrid labs, so I'm here back in Grand Rapids for the first bit of the semester while I do have those face-to-face interactions. But then once the hybrid labs go fully online, all the rest of my classes are fully online. So I will be moving back to Mason where I have much better Wi-Fi. I'm using borrowed Wi-Fi here. It's not a good setup. So I will be moving back to Mason for that. So let me share my screen again. Yeah. I did walk to work every day. Let's see, some things I love to do. I keep bees. Yeah. So Dr. B keeps bees. I like to crochet. My husband, he homebrews. I work with, I love animals. So I've got Pearl here. Oh, she's not here right now. She's snoozing in the bedroom, but this is Pearl. These are my former dogs and Hamlin that I love to torture when I'm home in Mason. I do specialize in bats so that's a little bit about me. We like to geocache, which is a really fun game. It gets us outdoors. Now let me tour The Blackboard site. Yeah, this is the video we're recording right now. You're watching it. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is start with the orientation. Okay, so start here in the orientation. And of course, the first thing it's going to tell you is to read the syllabus and the schedule. So the syllabus and the schedule are over here in the menu, or you could click this link and it will jump you right there. Is this the syllabus? That's the schedule. So I'm going to have to go there. Syllabus and schedule. These are some resources that you'll want to go through later. Let's start with that. So the syllabus. Now, lab is worth 25% of your microbiology grade, and lecture is worth 75%. And you will have a separate Blackboard site for lecture. It's either you either have it with me or you have it with Kate Krieger. I don't know how she runs the lecture portion. So that's why we have a separate site and a separate syllabus for lab. Now, because lab is worth 25% of your total grade, to make it easier for you to keep track of things, I made it out of 250 points. And so the breakdown of that 250 points total is lab exercises and then your three lab exams and an unknown investigation. Now, the lab exercises are going to be via Google Forms. Okay, so once you get through the orientation, it's going to tell you to start unit one, and that means you're going to start the exercises in Google Forms. Which exercises do you need to do? Well, you need to check the schedule. So read the course syllabus and schedule. Let's take a look at the schedule. That's it right here. So we're going to break down everything according to week. And we're going to do about two lab exercises a week. So for this first week, you're going to need to complete the orientation and do lab exercises one and two. For my online class, you can just ignore this little bit about the hybrid set face-to-face stuff, okay? So this is just for you over here. And the Google Forms, to get to the Google Forms, our lab is broken down into three units. And so unit one is going to start with lab one. And these are the two labs that you need to do. So see, it says lab safety and aseptic technique, lab safety and aseptic technique. Now, these are the links to the Google form, and they're going to look like this. So this is the aseptic technique one. And the Google Forms are like an interactive way for you to experience the lab. So first and foremost, you need to look at the learning outcomes. These are the most important things that you need to take out of the Google form or out of the experience. These are the things that you need to be able to do. Okay, so read those and then continually be checking back to them as to whether or not you know, you're achieving those goals. So here's a little explanation of what we're going to do and some background information. You do not need to buy a manual. This is your manual. Okay. And so this is the background information. This is the questions. This is even supplementing the data because you're going to be doing this online. So here's some questions. And then you look, here's a procedure. And then here's some procedural questions. Now, remember that this is meant to be like a lab experience. So, you know, if I was in front of the lab and I was talking to you and I was, you know, explaining what aseptic technique was, and then I was, you know, interacting with you, I would say, okay, now, you know, can someone give me a definition of sterile, you know, in their own words? You know, what would something that is sterile look like? And so for some of these questions, they're just kind of helping to guide you through the experience. And the Google Forms are not always graded based on correctness. In fact, the majority of them are based on whether or not you completed them. Okay. The idea is that you are taking this class for yourself, for your family, for your future careers. And And so you are doing this because you need this content, right? And so I'm not gonna grade the Google Forms based on whether or not you got the content correct on the very first try, but rather we're gonna assess whether or not you know the content in the exams. Occasionally I do grade on correctness, and that's like, you know, in one of the labs, you have to do a calculation and you come up with a finite number. That's either right or wrong. And so you can either do that or you can't. And so then in that case, I will grade on the correctness of that particular answer. Most of the time at the end of the week when all the Google Forms close, I take your submissions and I look them through to see if you answered you know, completely, if you made a good effort. So don't just write like I don't know, or you know, if there's an application question that says yes or no and then explain, you need to explain. So things like that. And then I will transfer your grades from the Google Forms to Blackboard. So even though it's set up like a quiz so that I can ask you questions on the Google Form, don't interpret that as your grade, okay? I will transfer, I will, you know, assess it whether or not it's complete and on occasion if it's correct, and then I'll transfer that grade to Blackboard. Now, when I do that transfer, I'll send you an email that says lab grades are posted, you know, and I will explain to you whether or not I graded on completeness or correctness. And if it was correct, what I graded. So the other thing is, when you submit your form, you will get a submission receipt in your email, and it'll say like view submission on it. And you can go back in and you can change your answers if you like. I don't care how many times you change your answers before the end of the week. That's not a problem. The idea is that you're learning, right? And you're practicing. There's also going to be feedback on these. So it'll explain, let's see. I'm trying to see if there's one of these that explains, did I not put feedback in these? Maybe a couple of these I will have feedback on them to explain why something is right or wrong. Oh yeah, I did. So here, feedback for correct answers or feedback for incorrect answers. So what you can do then is you can read the feedback and you know, decide if you're happy with your submission or not. And then at the end of the section, oh, I should also mention, sorry, I'm going to make you dizzy and sick here following my spinning thing. I tried to make this like a real lab experience. So you do kind of get to choose your own adventure, because in lab, you know, we have variable results a lot of times, depending on what each individual does or what each bench group does. So even though there are 7 sections of this particular form, it will give you like a little status bar across the top. If you skip to bench 4 to see bench 4's results, because that's the one that you thought was interesting, it's going to jump you to section 6. So you're going to skip sections. So don't panic about that. Okay. At the very end, the last section, there's usually some sort of application question, you know, some way for you to dig a little bit deeper. And everybody kind of ends on the same post lab section. So that is our lab exercises, okay? And that's explained here a little bit. Now the exams are going to be true, false, multiple choice, matching, ordering, and short answer. By short answer, I don't mean write a sentence. I mean like fill in the blank, like 1 or 2 words. Okay. And so the questions are going to directly correlate with the learning objectives in the lab exercise. When I sat down and wrote the exams, I said, okay, you know, lab 2, one of the learning outcomes is to be able to explain the purpose and goal of aseptic technique. How can I write a question about the purpose and goal of aseptic technique. Now, how can you be preparing for the exams? Well, you're working through the exercise and you can read the feedback and change your answers. You can also print out the lab exercises in PDF, which is like all four benches all at once. And you can try your hand at other benches. So you can, you know, take a look and see if, you know, your answer would have been different and if that would have been correct. You also, at the bottom of the units, there are practice worksheets. Now, the practice worksheets are set up to their Google Doc, and they're set up for you to make a copy. I don't know, do I have one of those open? No, I don't. Okay, so they're set up for you to make a copy. And they're, again, learning outcomes right at the top, because that's the most important. And then there are other ways for you to kind of do some self-checking. So you can fill these out like a worksheet and see how you did, you know, have you mastered those learning outcomes? And one other tip would be for you to, as you're reading through the practice questions in the lab and on the practice worksheet, to always try and figure out which outcome is that question addressing, because that's going to help you kind of knit that stuff all together. Okay. I'm lost. Oh, we were in the orientation. We were looking at the syllabus. Okay. So, and we looked at the schedule already, right? Yeah. So I will send you an email almost every week. The weeks close on Fridays. So I send them out on Fridays. That way you can start the week on the weekend by diving into the material. And then when I have office hours throughout the week, you can come to office hours and ask your questions, having already kind of engaged with the material so that you have an idea of what's going on. And so all the labs that are due. At the end of the semester, we'll have an unknown investigation project that is worth 10% of your grade. And because it's worth so much, you're going to identify two bacterial unknowns. What I have done is I have built in to the lab for you to identify unknowns on two previous occasions. So the 2 weeks before that, you're going to identify unknowns and you're going to write a conclusion and discussion section for each of those. So there's four here and there's four here. So you're going to end up writing a eight total conclusion and discussion sections to help you prepare for writing the final unknowns. And so even though it's a lot, I put a lot of low stakes stuff ahead of it to help you prepare. These are only worth 5 points each. So you're going to write four conclusion and discussion sections for a total of 5 points only. But that's intentional, because as you're learning, as you're preparing, and you're making mistakes, better to do that when the assessments are low stakes instead of the high points final assessment. And I did write a little incentive here that you can read later, but we'll talk about that much more at the end of the semester. I'll have a whole video for you and everything. Let's go back to the orientation. So you read the course syllabus and the schedule. There are some tips here. I actually talked about quite a bit of that with you, but that doesn't mean that there isn't really good stuff in there. Please do read through those tips. Join the group chat. So this is a link for you to send me an email, and you need to send me an email so that I can add you to the group chat. So if we go to chat.google.com, it's going to pull up my private one, I bet. Yep, that's my personal Google account. It's one of my dogs, and then my work account. Now the chat is for all of us. So this is for the entire class, lab and lecture. So don't be intimidated or confused if you see other questions there that you don't understand. It's just one good place for all of us to get together and talk about micro. You are not required to use the chat because that's office hours. However, you are required to send me the email to be on the chat so that you have the option if you need to, okay? So you must complete that part. Let's see, orientation, you must complete that part. Next, you're gonna need to read the scientific names handout. That's in the assignment and Dropbox's resources. Remember, we're gonna be doing some of our writing for the final unknowns via a Dropbox, where you're going to submit your homework, not on a Google form, but actually to Blackboard itself. And so there's a lot of resources here for that, but because it's at the end of the semester, I'll save it, but you do need to read this. You need to read that very first thing, because as you're recording your data in the Google Forms, you're going to be asked to upload your tables and your drawings to Google Forms, you know, your results and observations, and you need to be writing scientific names properly when you do that. So that's one of the things. And then you need to practice your Dropbox submission. So there's an article about learning, some questions to answer. These aren't right or wrong questions. They're just kind of get to know you opinion questions, and then a Dropbox to submit it to. These are good questions to kind of help you center how you're going to regulate your own learning and how you're going to approach the task of learning, right? And then you can begin unit one. So I think that's it. The only other important things that I need to tell you is, again, if you want to communicate with me, chat is the best way. That's why you're required to at least be on it. If you do need to send me an email, I understand you must include your section. It will be an alphanumeric thing like D, 6728 or something like that. And so I need to know that because I'm teaching a lot of sections this semester, and different classes, a micro lab lecture, different bio 101. So I need to know who you are to keep track of it all. Once I go back home to Mason, office hours are going to change. So I'm starting with chat office hours on Mondays. And then I'll have chat office hours on Wednesdays after a certain date. And I'll also have Zoom office hours on Thursdays. And all of that stuff is going to be in the communications folder with some explanations over here. So resources, right? All your resources are over here. Communication resources. FAQs, please read those. Those are very important. They're common questions that I get. Really, really important for you to read. And then different ways to communicate with me and each other. And then here's my schedule. Okay, so I think that's it. Gosh, I was hoping to keep this video short, but it's just so much to tell you all in the first little bit, but I'm really excited about this semester for us. I think that you're going to learn so much, and I think that it's going to be so cool because microbiology is just so cool, and we're going to find ways to apply that to our real life. And so I'm looking forward to doing this with you. All right. I'll see you online. Bye now.